I'm here with Aliyah Johnson, the author of The Fabulous Moonshine, and it is the Seal of Excellence winner for RT May 2010. And for all of those out there, all those people out there that think that they're done with vampires, not done with vampires yet. Because moonshine does something really, really special with the genre. It's not only paranormal with vampires, it's also urban fantasy, historical, romance. You get a little bit of everything in there.
Yeah, I kind of, when I came up with the idea, it was just everything. I was coming up with something that I would like. It was sort of like a testing myself if I could come up with a vampire story that I would really be interested in, since I'd been reading so many and I just kind of, I felt like I'd seen it all, although I'm sure I hadn't. But somehow the 1920s came to me and then vampires came to me, and something about those two just combusted into this amazing story. I just came up with it in a day, basically.
And I was going to say, and I think that's what makes your book so special, is Moonshine is the title of the book, of course, and it alludes to the two separate
right.
things, both the vampires and moonshine, as in bootlegging,
right,
prohibition.
And prohibition.
And I absolutely loved the fact that it was set in New York City back in the day, like you said, the 1920s.
Yeah.
So you not only have all of these others and all of kind of these monsters roaming the streets, but you also have the whole another level of social activism. There's a lot of changes happening
right,
during that time.
Right. I mean, to me, that metaphor, I mean, a lot of people have done the vampires as social underclass or social minority. Charlene Harris sort of like vampires as gay people. You know, there's a lot of things going on, but I thought that the 20s was a kind of perfect period where a lot of that stuff was kind of bubbling up, and it was going to break open after the crash and in the depression. But it was like there's this kind of veneer of high society and party living, and then this underclass of all these immigrants and all these poor people in the slums of the Lower East Side. And it just seemed like adding vampires and other supernatural creatures was like it was almost made to happen. I barely had to think about how to integrate it. It just worked the second I came up with the idea. It just seemed to flow.
And I think that's also very indicative of your work, is it does flow. You're reading it and you just can't put it down. It just goes one passage to the next. And there's a lot of really unusual things happening. In fact, our publisher, Carol Stacey, when she was reading it, that's what she said, that she's like, you just never know what's coming. It's so unusual and it's so, you know, I don't want to say weird, but in a way, it's so different from anything you might have read before. Is that what you were going
yeah,
for?
Yeah, no, I definitely wasn't, because like I said, I'd been reading all of these things, and I liked a lot of them, but I started to have this kind of feeling that especially the heroines were really similar. I wanted Zephyr, my main character, to kind of come from a slightly different place, to want slightly different things. And I also, like, my inner social activist has always been screaming every time I read these other vampire novels. I keep thinking, but they seem to have emotions and feelings. Why do they keep killing them?
I felt bad for the vampires
every time. Like, I watched all of Buffy feeling bad for the vampires that Buffy was killing. So I thought that I should have someone stand up for them.
I like it. And Zephyr, great main character. I was wondering her name, because I know names are very important
in your
work. So her name, is it Westerly Wind or is it the graffiti artist? Or neither?
Okay, Westerly Wind, but part of it was, and this was kind of strange, but there is Lloyd Alexander, you know, who did the Pride and Chronicles, this YA series. He's a really big fantasy YA writer. Also wrote this series of young adult adventures in the Napoleonic era with this kind of Lara Croftish like girl adventurer called Vesper Holly. And I loved these books growing up. And I remember when I was coming up with her name, I had this weird moment where I was like, you know that you're kind of echoing that name. Like, I know.
But it's an homage, really. It's not stealing, it's an homage.
You know, Zephyr Hollis, Vesper Holly. I loved her so much. She was one of my favorite characters growing up. I really wanted to be able to write a female lead who was capable and cool and funny in that way.